Hello, so I've decided to do something for my vibrato every day for the near future, or for the farther future. I started 2 days ago, and yesterday in the masterclass, Julie, the masterclass teacher, I asked her about vibrato and sound, because the topic of the class was sound production, and I listened to videos where the playing of Kreisler and Heifetz, and I think Tosha Seidel was put side by side, and I think my ears have changed, but I've always found that Kreisler's vibrato is such an integral part of his sound. Like, it is like the bass component, or a bass component of his sound. It's something that's always there. And of course, I mean, that doesn't mean it's always the same, but it also means that it kind of is interwoven with the quality of his sound. And that seems to me very special, and also I find that very touching and attractive as a role model perhaps for myself. So, I mean, that's an easy target to play like Kreisler, right? Okay, so it also, I'm also kind of combining this with the ideas of Baroque players for vibrato, or what we know about the right through writing, how people at the Baroque times approached vibrato. And one is, okay, they considered it as an ornament, which would not mesh well with this Kreisler idea, but also they described it as a Bebung in German, and that means I don't know, a Bebung could be like an earthquake, but the sound is more like a very, very small and quiet murmuring earthquake, or murmuring movement. So the way I want to approach vibrato is by just enlivening the sound, so it's not like this big thing on top of it. And I mean, I don't want to talk in any, I don't know, derogatory sense about other ideas of vibrato. So, but I'm not so much drawn to this big, romantic, dramatic vibrato. So, I mean, I was happy not having much of a vibrato at all, but now I think I hear how it can really make the sound itself more beautiful, and so I want to have that kind of component. And Julie suggested just to take a single piece that I would work on every day for a bit, and then put it aside. And so I decided to take a fiddle tune, one of the slower ones. And what came to my attention recently was the Cradle song by Skinner. So I'm starting with that. And then the other suggestion she gave me, and this is to kind of take the struggle and maybe also the big expectations out of it, is to just decide maybe on a single finger per day. I work on a single finger and play all the notes of the song that I can play with one finger with vibrato, and the others I won't. Maybe I can also disregard the rhythm or whatever, or I could vibrate only the final notes, or maybe the highest notes of a phrase or whatever. So it doesn't even have to make sense musically. So it is in a musical context. It is not like a vibrato exercise, because I've done lots of vibrato exercises and they never feel kind of interesting to me, and then therefore I also don't give them all the love that they would need. So I can go through the motions and, I don't know, cross off, well, I did these exercises, but it shows it doesn't really do anything for me, right? So I have this, of course. It's just that I'm a very special person and I need my own very own treatment, and I'm not like everyone else. Okay, so I've put myself into a corner with my vibrato practice, and this is a way maybe to get out of it. It's worth a try. So I also want to practice the song, the cradle song. I want to learn it. I mean, it's not a big song, but I want to learn it from memory right from the beginning, and so that I can focus on these vibrato islands I intend to do. So for today, I'm just doing the very first half phrase, like without anything. It's like this. Let's get this little shift from the E to the C sharp all the way. And I don't know if the rhythm was anything like it's written here. It has 8th notes and then 2 quarter notes and then a half note. So if those are the quarter notes, okay, so I practiced a little bit. So my finger of the day will be the second finger. So just because the second finger is my best vibrato finger, perhaps. And so I did a little bit of, this is in A major. And way of practicing vibrato that I got from Daniel was to support the scroll, and I did that where I can't do a video very easily. So just to have any kind of support, I'm supporting this on my music stand. I think it doesn't matter that it is. Downward, so like just do the C sharp second finger, so I don't know if you can see that. So for the mechanics of the movement, I just have to find some way of either doing it with the wrist or with the arm so that this joint moves, it goes flat and the other way. And I want this really to be part of the part of the sound, right? That's why I was kind of starting just to get it going with this very slow movement. So one idea I can incorporate that I like everything, I got everything from Daniel, right? And so what I want to take advantage here is that if the finger like hits the fingerboard, then there's some kind of a little bit of an impulse that can be translated into a vibrato movement. So for the second note, for the C sharp, the first time the second finger is played. I hate it that the C sharp is out of tune, but it's not really the purpose, so not getting too upset about it. So I think that worked really well, so I was happy. It's to also vibrate the F sharp with the third finger. I think I can do that right away, so I don't have to just do the second finger. But I'm not worrying about any of the first fingers right now. Okay, so now so I didn't finish my sentence, but what I was listening to was the sound from the bow. So it was kind of surfacey. I mean, it's supposed to be soft, but it shouldn't be sound so grainy, more like soft and silky, like some, I don't know, strain of silk. I so maybe I shouldn't expect too much and leave out the F sharp for now. Also, then I'm depending a lot on the scroll support, so I'm not doing the next step now because that is getting already 15 minutes video. Okay, so I'll just leave it with that.